I just lose weight, yet weight loss is the largest industry in the world today. My name is Kate Kibara. I'm a clinical nutritionist, and I'll be giving you tips on why you don't lose weight or what we need to do if you want to lose weight and maintain that weight loss for us to keep healthy and looking better. So there are basic things that we need to address when it comes to weight loss. And most of the time what happens when you stand on a scale and you've added a few kilos, the thing we rush to is just, what is the easiest way for me to lose weight, or what can be done immediately for this weight to go off? But there's so many factors that we need to look at. And if you meet today, when if you meet people today, most of my clients say, I'm doing everything right, but it's still not working. So what factors do you need to look at when you're losing weight? Number one, you need to address your family history. Research tells us if you come from a family where both parents are big, chances are that you have that tendency of becoming big. It also tells if one parent is big, you have that tendency. So this tells if you're trying to lose weight, you need to be a little bit more patient, need to be a little bit more strict, because chances of you becoming big are really easy compared to somebody who comes from a family history where they are not obese or where they are not big. Secondly, you need to look at your medical history. You also need to look at if you're taking any medication that could be interfering with your weight loss process. Another reason or medical reason could be you're taking medication. You could be taking drugs like steroids that are making you add weight, and you're trying so much to push this. So it's important to work with your physician. Let's just sit down to be checked. Is it something that I'm taking? Is it my condition that is making me not lose this weight as much as I'm trying? And when you rule this out, then you will know the other factor is your lifestyle. Are you sedentary? You know, sometimes you find that we're trying to lose weight, but we concentrate so much on what we're eating and forget that you actually need to be physically active for you to burn fat. You don't burn fat through eating. What you do, you build muscles that burn fat. And then lastly, and the main important aspect, is your diet. We do a lot of mistakes when it comes to weight loss programs, when it comes to what we're eating when we are trying to lose weight, and this actually now makes us not get to our desired results. So simple tips and points that we need to do. Basically, of course, the first thing you need to do, look at those factors and just change your kitchen, change your cooking methods, change everything, and start including foods that you have that you don't normally use in your diet. And this tells you you need to plan. Plan how you're going to lose this weight, plan the foods that you're going to include, and ensure that the plan that you make is realistic. You can work with your physician, you can work with your nutritionist when it comes to planning, and make realistic goals. Don't expect to lose 20 kilos in 2 days or 20 kilos in 10 days. After planning, then you need to look at the diet mistakes that we go through, and that means what we eat, what we provide on our tables that actually makes us add that weight as much as we're losing. A common factor is when we get into this strict diet, may I call them strict diets, that we take all the time. You decide that because I'm trying to lose weight, the only meals that I'm going to be taking are only high protein meals. And this is common because we are told that our starches, our breads and our starches, our carbohydrates, will actually, because they're high in energy, will actually make you add weight. So we end up concentrating on proteins. So not knowing that when you're taking too much protein, which will be used for energy because you're not providing carbohydrates for the same, which are the main source of energy, you'll be breaking down your proteins. The proteins would be used for building up your body. They'll be broken down for energy, and this can lead to serious conditions. It can lead to ketosis, and it could even eventually have problems with your kidneys, problems with your system. So it is important to ensure that it's not only one food group or one food item that you're going to do. You're providing everything, and what you're looking at is variety. You're reducing the number of calories or items that you eat, foods that you eat every day, and actually you're matching that up with your lifestyle. Secondly, apart from those crazy diets that we get into, we think, okay, it's today morning, I'm trying to lose weight, so I'm not going to be eating. I'll starve the whole day and I'll only take one meal. And maybe that meal could be, I'll just do salads. Or maybe that meal could be, I'll only do some special drinks. Yet not knowing that your body requires energy throughout. And the less you eat, the more weight you gain. Thirdly, another mistake that we do, we have this craze or this new thing that you need to take a lot of juices, you need to take a lot of fluids. You decide like for a month or 3 weeks, you're only taking fluids without taking the other food groups that are important. This in a way may be beneficial if it's a 2-3 day cleanse, but if you're going to use it for weight loss, what happens after you come off it? Sometimes you find that if it's not directed by your physician or your nutritionist, as soon as you're out of this crazy juice detox, maybe that's what you are taking, you find that you go back to your normal eating habits. And when you go back to your normal eating habits, it does not help because you're going to put back what you had lost during that time. When it comes to your proteins, those are your carbohydrates, ensure that you take less of the red meat. We know why. Because red meat is a culprit for high in cholesterol, and actually if you take in excess, makes you add weight. So the idea here is to take one protein meal in a day, and if it is meat from animal protein, then you need to take about 40-50 grams of meat in a day, meaning if you had a quarter meat, it should last you a week. And the best type of meat is white meat. So if you had your chicken, if you had your fish, and chicken is organic, of course, you remove the skin. If you have your fish, you do the same. You ensure that you're taking just one protein meal in a day. And then the other days, you alternate with vegetable source of protein. So sometimes you can do beans. Sometimes you can do dengu. So you're combining different proteins. So you're actually getting all the nutrients as you're losing weight and you're watching on the portions. Even if you had hunger pains and you're going to take this high, a lot of food, the salad will actually make you, will suppress your appetite. So you do that. Another tip you can also do are soups. You can make a soup, you know, you boil something, whether it's a carrot soup or pumpkin soup, to have before the meal so that you're able to eat less if you feel that you're getting hungry. When it comes to your fruits, if you're going to eat a lot of fruits that are also high in sugar, let's talk about the banana, for example, and you're making a smoothie with avocado every day. As much as it's healthy, it's still high in calories, it's still sugar, and it will make you add weight. So you'll take variety. So today, if you want to do your banana, tomorrow you do an apple. If you want to take juices, you work with fruits that are low in sugar. So you can decide to do watermelons, but you can combine. But the idea here is to have a diet that is about 2 weeks long, so you won't be repeating the same foods over and over again. And when you do that, you find that you're able to balance your glucose, you're able to balance your energy, and you start seeing a steady process where you're losing this weight. It also tells you that it is not what you're eating that is wrong. It is how we combine this food. It is what we put on our tables, and it is how often and how frequently you take this food. And ensure you don't stay hungry. If you get hungry, you can snack on something you like. You could do grapes, you could do nuts and seeds, something that is healthy, but it's also making you watch your weight. Lastly, you don't give up, because sometimes it's very difficult to lose weight. It could be difficult at the beginning, but don't give up, because you'll see results with time if you follow the tips for weight loss. And lastly, don't forget that you must exercise, because exercising is part of a healthy system. It's part of changing your lifestyle into a more healthier one. And if you follow these tips, I'm very sure that you'll be able to lose and maintain this weight.